I got to be good in about an hour or more. That's pretty cool. Second Corinthians chapter 12. We've used Apostle Paul as illustration, but I've been working on this the last two or three days, and I just want to dig a little deeper. Talk about the thorns of life. See what we can get from this. How many of you have been swimming in a lake or ocean or whatever, and you felt something nibbling at your leg? Bounce, whatever. That's annoying because you don't know what it is. Well, that's what a thorn is. It's an annoyance. It's some kind of a disability, hindrance. And it's not always pleasant. So we have to try to get the most out of it that we can, and hopefully Paul can help us to understand it a little better, the thorns of life, and help us to use them for our benefit. We, you know, old Nicholas, the preacher, got on his 60th birthday. He got a new suit from his congregation. They bought him a brand new suit. Boy, he's so happy. The next Sunday, he wore it. And he got up to preach, and he said, "I'm so thankful for my new suit that everyone bought me last week for my birthday. And today, I'm preaching in my new birthday suit." Second Corinthians, you can't just sit down and do nothing. You gotta, keep moving.
Amen.
Second Corinthians chapter 12, let's begin with verse 6. Second Corinthians chapter 12, beginning in verse 6. This is the Apostle Paul. "For I would desire to glory, I shall not be a fool, for I will say the truth, and now I forbear, lest any man should think of me above that which he seeth me for being, or that he heareth of me." And Paul said he's having problems, I guess, people thinking more highly of him than they should. In verse 7 he said, "Lest I should be exalted above measure through the abundance of the revelations." Now, in Acts 2:38, chapter 14, verse 19, the Bible talks about Paul being stoned at Lystra. And the first four verses of this chapter talks about a man that was died going to heaven. And he saw things that he wasn't able to speak about. But Paul was blessed in so many different ways that he had to have this thorn in order to humble himself. In verse 7, there was given to me a thorn in the flesh, the messenger of Satan, to buffet me lest I should be exalted above measure. The Lord is the one who has to get the honor for everything that's done. Verse 8, for this thing I besought the Lord thrice or three times that it might depart from me. But he said unto me, my grace is sufficient for thee, for my strength is made perfect in weakness. Most gladly, therefore, will I rather glory in my infirmities, that the power of Christ may rest upon me. Therefore, I take pleasure in infirmities, in reproaches, in necessities, in persecutions, in distresses for Christ's sake. For when I am weak, then I am strong. As I said, a thorn is it's an annoyance, it's a disability, it's a hindrance of some sort. We have no idea what this thorn was that the Apostle Paul had to face every day. But it came from the messenger of Satan, one of the devils that Satan has access to. He was behind it, made sure that it happened every day. And this messenger, whatever it was to buffet Paul. That word buffet means to beat. Might have been a spiritual beating, might have been an emotional beating, it might have been a physical beating, I'm not sure. But the reason for it was that he should be exalted above measure. God used this buffeting to humble Paul. Now, it's hard for us to think like God thinks. I mean, to me, thorns, I can do without them. But the Bible teaches us that that's how we grow as a Christian, by the thorns of life. If we didn't have thorns, if we didn't have things that happen to us, a hindrance, and these annoyances, if we didn't have them, we could never mature and be what God would have us to be. Now, I don't like them any more than you do, but they're necessary. One thing they teach us, we learn. I probably never learned anything from sunshine in good times, beautiful day. I mean, what is there to be concerned about or even worry about or learn from it? Beautiful sunshiny day, and I've had plenty of them, and I'm sure you have too. But these thorns toughen us. Most of us are too thin-skinned, and these thorns will toughen us up, make us tougher, make us more enduring, able to take more things and receive more things and keep on moving for God. But they also tender us through the thorns of life. They teach us to sympathize with others and empathize with others. I guarantee you, if you've lost a child through death or you've had children and went through some real bad physical problems or whatever, those things touch you. And when I was growing up, a young man, I saw somebody suffering, didn't bother me, and you know, get off my neck, you know, who cares? Take it the best you can, do the best you can with it. I didn't worry about anybody or anything, didn't care about anybody or anything. But boy, since I've gotten some thorns in my life, it sure slowed me down a whole lot. And it teaches us to sympathize with others. And then it tests us. faith without being tested is not faith. The only way that my faith can be strengthened is through thorns. I mean, God can't do it any other way.
Amen.
That's just the way it is. And whatever thorns you go through in life, they're there. God placed them there to toughen you.
Amen.
And to help you grow in grace. And you can't get by without them. Like I say, I don't like them. You probably don't. Nobody does. Paul didn't like it. How would you like for this messenger to visit with you every day and stick the thorn in here? No one would like that. But God's message was, my grace is sufficient for thee.
Amen.
My strength is made perfect in weakness. And Paul's testimony was, when I'm weak, then I'm strong.
Amen.
I mean, when this thing gets me every day, this thorn hits me every day, and I have to put up with this thing every day, then I'm weak. It's hard, I know, but it makes me stronger than doing without it. He learned to depend upon the Lord through his weakness. And folks, let me assure you, the best thing in the world for us to do when we're going through a tough time, when we're facing a thorn, and boy, it's gouging us, the best thing to do is ask God to help you.
Amen.
Put it in God's hands and trust the Lord. Don't take your focus off of him, regardless of the circumstance. We say we're too weak to do God's work. That's why he chose us. He chose the weak things of the world to confound the wise. I mean, he wants a weak person to serve him. He wants somebody that's weak, can't make it on their own, so they'll depend on him.
Amen.
And through depending on him, he makes us strong. That's why I keep saying, keep your focus on the Lord. And I wonder how many times, though, where the angels looked at Jesus and says about me, mug him again, Jesus. Mug him again. Give him another thorn. He's not behaving properly. And when we need to be changed, we need the thorns. You know, I don't know about you, but we see everybody else through our own eyes and not the eyes of the Lord. When I look at everybody else, you know, probably the same way, I'm thinking, boy, they ought to be changed. Lord, you need to change my husband, and this is the way I want you to change it. Lord, I want you to change my wife. This is the way I want you to change my wife. Lord, my pastor and my preacher sure need to be changed. This is the way I want you to change it. You think God pays any attention to that? No. He's using that mean old husband to toughen you. That's a cross. That's a thorn. It's not a cross. It's a thorn. And God uses it to gouge you every once in a while. Does that mean wife? Well, I forgot you were sitting there. Gouge you every once in a while. And he uses this old preacher to gouge you every once in a while. We need that.
Amen.
It's necessary. And when I look at somebody else and I say, Lord, they sure need to be changed. You know who needs to be changed? Our preacher is the one that needs to be changed. And I understand that. The Lord permits the thorns in our lives to bring about that necessary change. And Paul said he had a problem. Lest I should be exalted above measure. There were many things that could cause him to just puff up and be proud. Did you know the Bible teaches us that he was a as far as his heritage, he was a Hebrew, the Hebrew. I mean, you know, he was a Hebrew, the Hebrew. Not many people can say that. Not only that, he was a Roman citizen. He didn't buy it, he earned it. And as far as his education, the greatest scholar of his day taught him, Gamaliel. His position in life, he was part of the Sanhedrin. Remember the Sanhedrin? The power he had received from the Pharisees and the Sanhedrin. You can go all over the country, arrest every Christian that you can find, and put them to death. I mean, and then his salvation experience. He got saved on the road to Damascus. You know about that? His calling to go to the Gentiles. And then, of course, all the special revelations. Died. What the heck? And God sent him back to keep your mouth shut. You can't tell what you saw. And his position as an apostle. He said, I was as one born out of time. In other words, Judas is not a member of the 12 anymore. Paul took his place. He was born out of time, he said. Should have been numbered with the 12. And so we find out that he had so many things that would make him proud. And in verse 7, God had to take care of that pride. And the process was, there was given to me a thorn in the flesh. The Greek word for thorn, you know what the Greek word for thorn is? It's a pointed stake. It's like a stake somebody was taking and driving into your skin. And sometimes we go through things, man, it just stabs us. It's like a pointed stake. And he said, the messenger of Satan buffets me every day. Every day he comes by and sticks a stake in me. It's permanent. It's going to last until I die. It's painful. My goodness, it's painful. That's the reason he prayed and asked God to deliver him from that thorn, but God refused to do it. You need it, Paul. You gotta have it. The purpose of the thorn was to bring change to Paul's life. And the purpose of the thorns in our lives, like I say, we don't like it. We don't enjoy it necessarily. But it's for our benefit.
Amen.
It's to change us. And we've got to have it. What is your thought? You have one. Most everybody I know will experience thorns in their life. It may be a person. It may be a thing. It may be physical. It might be spiritual. It might be financial. It's just a thorn that just keeps stabbing you. And just remind yourself that this is necessary or God wouldn't have it here. It wouldn't be here if it wasn't necessary. God's never going to put anything in our lives that's not necessary. Whether it's a trial or a test, whatever it is, or a thorn that's gouging us, it doesn't make any difference. It's there for a purpose and a reason. Paul, just like anybody else, he sought relief. The Bible says he prayed three times, thrice. And I don't know if he prayed three times in a row, or 3 days in a row, or 3 weeks in a row, or how he did it, but he sure went to God and prayed and asked God to take this thing away. He said, I'll be a better man if you take this thorn away. God said, no, you'll be a better man if I leave it there. And you gotta have it. But verse 9 says he sought his resources. First thing he did was he sought God's grace. Pray, ask God to take it away. The word of God says in Psalm 119:92, unless thy law had been my delight, I should have perished in my afflictions. He sought God's grace. He sought God's work. He sought God's will, he humbled himself. He said, I'll glory in my affliction. And the scripture teaches us to humble yourself under the hand of God that he may exalt you in due time, casting all your cares upon him, for he cares for you. Let me encourage you, whatever thorn you may be enduring, whatever thorn it is that's causing you pain, whatever thorn it might be that you might be going through even this day where it's stabbing you, seek God's help.
Amen.
And God may take it away, but if he doesn't take it away, I guarantee you, he'll use it to help you. And he'll give you grace and strength to bear it, to endure it. Paul, the position he ended up with in verse 10, Paul said, therefore I take pleasure in infirmities and reproaches, in necessities and persecutions, in distresses for Christ's sake. For when I am weak, then I am strong. Paul said, I accept this thorn because it will change me and will help me to be usable for the Lord. And that's basically the lesson for everyone out. When the thorns of life come and they gouge us and we're not enjoying this, and this is hard on me, Lord, help me, Lord, take it away. And if you don't take it away, give me grace and strength to deal with it and to bear it. And he always does. He always has, and he always will. But we must remember that the thorns are there for a purpose and for a reason. As we studied the life of Moses, this man was self-sufficient. He was, you remember how his life was saved, and Pharaoh's daughter took him in and raised him, and he got the best education in Egypt, and best soldier learning and teaching that you can get. I mean, he had it all, but he never forgot. His mother always reminded him and kept him in remembrance that who he was. He was really a Hebrew, and this is his people that the Egyptians had under bondage, and they were suffering. You remember one day he saw this guard or whoever mistreating one of the Hebrews, and he just killed him, buried him in the sand. Well, they told on him. He had to run for his life. But he thought that because of who he was, that the people would follow him at that point in time. No, they didn't. He had to go to the desert, and he had to put up with the thorns for 40 years. And in fact, he was 80 years old before he got to the point where God could use it to lead the Israelites. And when God called him, he said, well, who am I? I don't have the ability to lead these people. He said, what shall I say unto them? He lacked a message, didn't know what to say. He said, they will not believe me, his lack of authority. He said, I'm not eloquent. I can't speak well. He said, send somebody else. What? Just send somebody else. He said, why hast thou chosen me and sent me? Look at me, where I am. I had all that training and everything. Here I am, a shepherd out here in the middle of nowhere. How shall Pharaoh hear me? He'll pay attention to me. Why did God use Moses with all his weaknesses that he had? Well, no flesh shall glory in my sight, God said. And so remember, folks, God expects us to be weak. He wants us to be weak. And he uses thorns to keep us weak. Why does he want us to be weak and not depend on ourselves? So we will depend on him.
Amen.
That's the whole story. shared this with others. Now, because I have a tendency to be proud of who I am and what I've done and what I'm doing and what I've seen, God had to give me this thorn in the flesh so that he can keep me weak and I would depend upon him. Why Paul? Why not somebody else? Because God knew who Paul was, and God knew the temperament of Paul, and God knew that Paul would yield to him regardless of what he brought into his life, and that Paul would be submissive to him. I'm like everybody else. I say my tough times, but I would have hated to be called as a Christian as Paul was. You know what the Lord said about Paul? I'm going to show him what he has to suffer for my sake. It was called to suffer. I mean, you were saved, sin forgiven, me too, so we can go to heaven one of these days. Paul, of course, is in heaven. We read about, you know, he said a lot about it. But he was called to suffer. You know what God said about you when you got saved? I'm going to show you how much you're going to have to suffer for my sake. Well, what a calling that would be. No, God says, my grace is sufficient for thee. I sympathize with you. I understand what you're going through. I know these are tough times for you. But I'll give you grace. Just keep on going. Keep your focus on me. And I'll give you grace to get through all the thorns of life, day by day, whatever comes our way. He has promised to give us the grace, the strength, to wear off, just do whatever we have to do, and whatever is necessary. Isn't it good to know that sometimes we look at ourselves and say, well, I'm not sure if we, Chris, I don't know why you called me, or why you chose me, or why you want me on your team. It's because of our weakness that he can make us strong, and he can get his work accomplished through us. That's a great truth, folks. My idiot. Paul said, when I prayed three times, God wouldn't take it away. But he did tell me that he'd give me grace to bear it. And Paul was given grace by Jesus. How many times was he thrown in prison? And before it was all over with, they took Paul out, cut his head off, sent his soul to hell. Paul never once complained that I can find in all the scriptures. He wrote the book of Philippians, and he was constantly saying, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. And he encourages us to praise the Lord. Folks, this is the thing that I'm trying to get across to me, you, everybody. Keep your focus on the Lord.
Amen.
Don't focus on the thorn. That thing will wear you out. I mean, it'll be right there in front of you every day, 24 hours a day. If we focus on the thorn, that's all we're going to get done. You can't focus on the thorn. Keep your focus on the Lord, and let the Lord take care of the thorn. If it's a person, if it's a thing, if it's physical, spiritual, financial, whatever it is, put that thorn in God's and let the Lord take care of it. It's just like everything else. We have so little control over anything.
Amen.
I don't have any control over anybody or anything. It's like when you lay down on your bed at night, you have to depend on the Lord to give you sleep.
Amen. Right.
How the world are you going to get sleep and rest if the Lord doesn't give it to you? How are you going to make it into life if the Lord doesn't help you? I've heard people say, well, I can't live the Christian life, brother, you told the truth.
Amen.
You can't do it by himself. We have to have God's help. I'm thankful that, like I said this morning, he gives us friends to help us along the way. He gives his presence as a reality at all times. And he's got thousands of angels ministering to us all the time. But next time you are gouged by this thorn, you just remember he's right there with you. He loves you. He's trying to help you. He's making some necessary changes in you that need to be made. He'll never leave you nor forsake you. And he'll provide whatever you stand in need of to get through that and to make it through. He always has and he always will. Thank God for his marvelous grace. God is good.
Amen.
God is good. Keep your focus on him. Give those thorns to him. Let him take care of them. And just keep your focus on him. Keep moving with him. Would you stand on this plate? I guess about my Christians are praying.